Yes, Kenya. Tamu sana, tamu sana, tamu sana, yes. The situation is getting out of control. William Ruto clearly has no plan, no clue of bringing down the cost of living. Each passing day, that cost is shooting up. We have seen in Tanzania, for example, they have lowered their petroleum products. In Kenya, it's shooting. Globally, the price is coming down. In Kenya, we are being told the price globally is going up because of Hamas-Israel war. So everything in Kenya is shooting up. And the most interesting bit about it today, we are being told that to get a new ID, if you've never had any ID, you'll need 1,000 Kenya shillings. Previously, it was free. If you want a replacement of your ID, all along it has been 100, now it will be 2,000 Kenya shillings. If you are a Kenyan and you give birth outside of Kenya, for your child to be a Kenyan citizen, you'll need over 1 million Kenya shillings for your child to be a Kenyan citizen. Let's have a look at a very interesting post by Pauline Njoroge about 1 hour ago. Pauline Njoroge, getting an ID if you are not previously registered was free. It will now cost you Kenya shillings 1,000. Replacement of ID was previously Kenya shillings 100. It will now be Kenya shillings 2,000. Passport application fee has also been increased with over 50%. Serikali ya hustlers inatupeleka vizuri kwa mwendo wa aste aste. Yes, it's getting sweeter. Tamu sana hii. And it's actually true if you look at the Kenya Gazette today. If you look at Kenya Gazette, the Registration of Persons Act, and then jump down there. Jump down there. Identity card fees. Not previously registered, current charge is free. New charge, 1,000. Duplicate or replacement, current charge, 100. New charge, 2,000. Change of particulars, current charge, 1,000. New charge, 1,000. Good. Identification reports, current charge, 300. New charge, 1,000. Civil servant's card, current charge, 100. New charge, 1,000. And then I think staff badges, current charge, 350. New charge, 1,000. Dated 6th November 2023. Kithure Kindiki, Cabinet Secretary for Interior and National Administration. That's the Kenya Gazette, 7th November. I think it's 7th November. 7th November. Yes, that's about 2 days ago. Those are the new charges, ladies and gentlemen. So it appears William Ruto is on a mission to tax everything. And very soon, even being a Kenyan, you will be paying to be a Kenyan. just being called a Kenyan, you will be paying something. At this rate, I'm seeing that as a possibility in the coming days. And yesterday, while addressing Kenya Kwanza members of parliament, when they were saying that the high cost of living is making us unpopular on the ground, what did William Ruto tell them? He told them that popularity only matters at the right time. We don't have an election now. Let's wait for 2027 there, and then we start doing things that will make us popular. Ruto told Kenya Kwanza members of parliament that for now, they should not be thinking about being popular on the ground. Look at what this government is doing. Oil prices globally are coming down. In Tanzania, we have seen they've reduced prices of petroleum products. In Kenya, the prices are going up. And we are being told, you know, it's because of this Israel-Hamas war. That's what the government is telling us. And we are being told that is going to hit 300 Kenya shillings per liter. If you look at the price of these petroleum products, half of it goes to tax. That's what a hustler's government is doing. And some Kenyans are still cheering up, ululating, saying, give him time, bwana, give him time, give him time. If you're watching us but you're not yet subscribed, subscribe, give this video a like. What does this all mean, ladies and gentlemen? It's a fact. William Ruto has no solution to what Kenyans are going through. He has no solution at all. He has no plan. He will never get it right. And for those who have been following me here, I've always maintained that even if given 100 years, this government will never get it right. And the simple reason is Ruto and his team are very clueless. They are very naive in matters governance. And now you can see the clear picture as to why Uhuru had a lot of difficulties. I'm very sure that if Uhuru Kenyatta was running the government alone as Uhuru Kenyatta, he could have performed far much better than he did. And the problem is now coming out as William Ruto and his team who had hijacked the government. Everything is being taxed. And the most annoying bit about it, we are not seeing any development. We are seeing taxpayers' money being wasted aimlessly. Our president in just under 1 year, he has made over 40 trips. Kibaki, the person he says he wants to be like, made only about 34 trips in his 10-year tenure. In the 10-year tenure, he had. This one saying he wants to be like Kibaki has made over 40 trips in under 1 year. Wasting taxpayers' money, roaming the world, but we are seeing no benefit. No benefit at all. A whole president saying that he's looking for jobs for Kenyans in Saudi Arabia. A president sanctioning modern day slavery of his people, saying that Kenyans were gonna be de, honestly. Kenyans were gonna be de sana. So a president sanctioning enslavement, misuse of his people in a foreign land. We are planning to send 1,000 troops to Haiti. Taxpayers' money being wasted on that. a government increasing its size, unnecessary positions, CAS positions that Kenyans don't need. Controller of budget just about 3 days ago dropped a bombshell that if you look at these salaries of these civil servants, in the budget estimates, they are almost tripled. So that the excess amounts are going to men and women's pockets, corrupt men and women in this government, a hustler's government. This is a topic we can talk the whole day. Let me stop it there for now. Let's meet in our next analysis. In case you want to support our forum, contact me through that number below or feel free to channel your support to that number. Thank you. God bless you. God bless Kenya.